Welcome back. You know, everyone needs a little boost at the end of the day, even kids, but you don't want to give them caffeine or sugar. Well, we have help today from Jennifer Cola Ericow with us. She is the cookbook author of The Sassy Spoon, and she joins us now with, you know, some recipes, some different treats that we can all use to manage our energy, right?
That's right, Destry. Thank you. And I'm also trying to keep in mind for people who are very busy, something that's convenient, easy to take with you. And also, you know, it's something wholesome and not something you would buy off a grocery shelf that's prepackaged.
Well, so that's the thing. A lot of people go, when they're on the go, they go with the prepackaged, but you say that's not the healthiest way to go. So what options do we have?
Well, let's start here, Destry. Let's think about leftovers, okay? So last night had a barbecue, and what this is right here is the leftover, and I wanted to show you how I rolled it, because this you can take with you the next day, okay, after you keep it in the fridge all night. But what I did is I had turkey burgers and took some leftover turkey burger, wrapped it in a tortilla with some barbecue sauce, cheese, and then we had some roasted veggies as well, so I just cut a few of those up.
So you just got your own tortilla out and immediately made
something.
Last night
while we were putting leftovers away, that's right, and then wrapped up. So this stays nice and tight throughout the whole day when you take it with you in your lunch pail or whatever.
You just have to do it right when you're done. That's the thing.
And that right there, the sweet potatoes, those were barbecued also. Those are delicious cold, so you just refrigerate them, and they're, for days, it's good as a cold snack. This is baked tofu, believe it or not, which is very delicious cold. It's like anything else that you would marinate. So again, when you're heating up the kitchen anyway, baking things and trying to make things in bite size.
And that way you can dice it and package it up and go.
And then what we've got there on the left is actually egg whites. So an egg white omelet.
This is egg whites?
Yeah, egg white omelets.
It's like making a tortilla.
That's right. Well, it's a very thin, I do very thin egg white omelets. And you can roll them up plain and eat them cold for a great protein snack, or like the second one has a little bit of cheese in there.
Oh, okay.
So you just roll that up. So again, those are things that are kind of incorporating foods you would have for breakfast, or maybe you barbecued the night before, that'll work for you for snacks throughout the next couple of days.
All right, these look really good.
This
is
really fun. I call these the Iron Man baked oatmeal bars, okay?
Baked oatmeal bars.
Right. Now, oatmeal is a very good, healthy breakfast, but not everyone has time to eat it, so myself included. So I decided, why don't I cook the oatmeal and bring it with me? So when I make oatmeal, like this is what I typically put in my oatmeal for lots of protein. You know, the oats.
Okay, so you started off with just regular oatmeal.
Oats, yep. Okay. I always put flaxseed.
Okay.
And protein powder.
How much protein powder do you put
depends.
In? Because you don't want it to taste funky.
No, and you know, this is a chocolate flavor. They have vanilla flavor. So it's really, for something about this size, I would put about 2 small scoops of protein powder in there.
Okay.
Some cinnamon and nuts of your choice. Those are walnuts. Almonds are very good. And then some soy milk, or you know, maybe a little bit of juice.
Because you want the protein and
and for
like
liquid, because again, we're going to be baking this. The other thing I put in here is applesauce, which I've got down there for later. But applesauce is actually a fat substitute. So since I'm going to be baking, I didn't want to put oil or shortening or butter in there.
So you put some applesauce in there.
Yep. And you can really put whatever fruit you want in. I've got blueberries and banana in here.
And I've tasted it. This is really good.
So as you notice, I don't have any baking soda. It's not really intended to be baked, but this would be oatmeal that I would cook in my microwave in the morning.
And it's very moist.
Okay? Yep. So you just put it in a baking dish, a pie dish, bake it at about 350 for 30 minutes,
and this is
ready
what you're going
to
wind up with.
Yep, you can take it with you.
And I think this is good for the kids, too.
It's very good. They think they're eating cake.
And
it's oatmeal. Yes.
All right. I like it. What do we have here?
Well, now, speaking of kids, this is my picky kid area, okay? And again, trying to think, they're going to be school lunches or maybe just some quick going to practice
lunches. Are so hard. Right? Oh, my gosh.
So there's all sorts of cute little, you know, containers out there now. But this is, you know, the famous celery with peanut butter. And I just put a little tiny apple slice in there to make it a little more exciting.
3-in-1, right?
That's right. And it gives it a very, very sweet taste. Had pancakes the other morning, blueberry pancakes. So what this is, and I don't know, let me take one out. Kids love these. So they feel like they're eating cake, and there's peanut butter and apple slices in here. So you take two, you know, apple or blueberry, whatever kind of whole grain pancakes you had been cooking. You can put peanut butter and some nice fruit, maybe even smashed
strawberries. And that's a good idea to put in, of course, for kids' lunches, too. It doesn't have to be a sandwich. You can use pancakes. All right,
really quickly,
let's go over the rest.
Sure.
You have these?
These are edamames and grapes, which kids love. Okay, and again, you can do things with peanut butter and even some dark chocolate chips with a child to kind of make them feel like they're doing something exciting and interesting. Now for at home, if you have a little more, you don't need to be portable as much, Greek yogurt and salsa mixed together make a wonderful dip on either crackers or right
that
on
is a, really
a baked
good idea.
Sweet potato.
Greek yogurt is like the thing these
protein,
days.
Protein, low fat, it's all very good. That. And same thing, that same Greek yogurt, this is savory, if you wanted to do something sweet, you could take your yogurt with your blueberries and applesauce, and that is delicious. The applesauce will sweeten the yogurt. You don't need any kind of honey or anything like that.
Great ideas. Of course, these are in your cookbook.
Yes, they are.
Keep that in mind. That's sassyspoon.com to find out more information or to get the cookbook online. Thanks so much.
Thank you.
Great.